We had said that the title of this lesson is Common Sense Reasoning. Let us dig a little bit deeper so that we can see where the common sense reasoning is coming here. Consider this sentence, Ashok put the wedge on the block. Imagine an AI agent that pulls out the frame for move object as a primitive action and fills in all of these slots, and by now we know how the agent can do that. If I would ask the AI agent, did Ashok's hand move when he was putting the wedge on the block, I would expect the AI agent to say yes, because that is what happens when people move the wedge to the block. They grasp their hands around the wedge, they move their hand, and then they release their fingers. Now, this is what common sense reasoning is about, making inferences that are not necessarily part of the input sentence here, but are part of the background knowledge that the agent has, so the agent can make inferences about the world, common sense inferences about the world. So the question then becomes, what is the knowledge that the AI agent must have so that it can in fact make the kind of inferences that we are talking about, common sense inferences? Suppose that the AI agent had not only knowledge of the primitive action move object, but also about some of the sub-actions. So here are some of the sub-actions for the given context. So in the context of moving wedges and blocks, the AI agent might already have a kind of micro story, which says that when actions get done and things get moved from one place to another place, then typically fingers are first closed around the first object, then the hand moves, and then the fingers are released around the second object.
So Ashok, if we can decompose move object into a series of move body part actions, was move object really a primitive action?
That's a valid question, David. Move object was indeed a primitive action related to the various superficial forms in which words can occur in a sentence, as an example, transported, carried, or moved. However, this primitive action move object can have its own story in terms of further decomposition. Notice this particular decomposition, this particular story is specific to the structure of the sentence where Ashok puts the wedge on the block. This raises lots of hard issues. How many such stories are there? Do we have a story? Must an AI agent have such a story for every single situation that it encounters? Those are hard questions. It is not clear that AI currently has an answer to all of those questions. So this theory by no means covers all stories. Many of these stories are beyond the scope of this theory. And in fact, even for the stories that are within the scope, there is a hard question about computational tractability because the number of such stories can explode very quickly.